Hello, and welcome to the Raymarcher official documentation, version 2.1.0. In this documentation, we will go through all the platform setup, and we will briefly check out the latest improvements. Setting up the Raymarcher is pretty easy. All you need is an existing scene, main camera, and target platform. So let's start with PC console. Go to the window, Raymarcher, and choose PC consoles. The warning window with further information will pop out. It basically says that our scene is going to be saved and prepared for the Raymarcher renderer. Press yes and there you go. If you select your main camera, you can see we've got all the required settings and we can now play with Raymarcher. Now, let's set up the PC VR platform, such as Oculus, Vive and so on. My scene already contains a ready VR player using XR extension with right controller and left controller. Go to the window, Raymarcher, and choose PC VR. The Raymarcher filter object will appear. The Raymarcher filter object is used as a screen to the Raymarcher world. Attach this object to the main VR camera, adjust the position and scale, lower down the near clipping plane on the camera, and you're ready to go. Please keep in mind that the Raymarcher for VR doesn't react with the Unity generic objects, as it's projected on the screen in different renderer and doesn't support depth buffer. Also, be careful with the performance, as it takes twice of it for VR. Let's set up the Raymarcher for mobile platform. Go to the window, Raymarcher, and choose mobile. The setup is practically the very same as for PC platform, so there is no reason for further steps. All I can say is to be careful building for mobiles, as the Raymarcher is very heavy for rendering. Also, the Raymarcher for mobiles doesn't support forward rendering path, uses deferred instead. Let's set up the Raymarcher for mobile VR platform, such as Pico-Neo or Oculus Quest. Go to the window, Raymarcher, and choose mobile VR. The setup is practically the very same as for PC VR platform, so again, there is no reason for further steps. Again, try to save as much performance as is possible. Raymarcher is pretty heavy for GPU. Let's set up the Raymarcher for WebGL. WebGL offers two options, low-end and high-end. Basically, the low-end will use the mobile Raymarcher framework, while high-end will use default PC Raymarcher framework. Use high-end if your WebGL app focuses mostly on realism and advanced stuff. Otherwise, use low-end for simple WebGL apps with basic functionality or simple fractal strips. Go to the window, Raymarcher, and choose your desired WebGL option. That was all for the Raymarcher setup. Now let's jump into the latest improvements and features. Raymarcher went through the huge source code refactor and renderer was optimized by 70%. The new update brings many new features, including new shading options, new visual additions, and plenty of new example scenes with music reaction feature and more. There are also a few products that verify the Raymarcher in commercial industry. Check them out in the description and explore the Raymarcher from your own point of view. Now you can use improved flat shading, toon shading, BBR or Lambert shading, and soft outline feature. Each shading option has a plenty of fields that contain tooltips and additional information for better use. Distance fog is a new field in the visual section that allows you to generate fog with custom density and color. Make your fractals more alive and feel the depth of infinity. Also, the maximum possible objects has increased by 35%. There are many new minor improvements, including new UI graphics, improved warning messages, debug messages, and added quality presets. It's practically more user-friendly without even less issues. I would like to thank every user who reported all the issues. You make the package even better. If you would like to learn how to use the Raymarcher, how to use the operations and other features, check out the previous documentation. The Raymarcher workflow hasn't changed since then. Thank you for your attention, and I wish you good luck.